Okay, so let's talk about the lateral distribution factors for the shear. And for the moment we have already finished in our previous class. Design name loaded, the value of G is equal to, let's talk about for interior bridge girder, G for shear is equal to 0.36 plus S over. I gave you the equations. Please check that whether this equation is correct or not. I have the equations. S over 7600. So what about S? S is the spacing of the girders. Just put the value. This is for the one lane loaded. This G equation is for how many lanes? It is for one lane loaded. One lane. So just put the value 0.36 plus what is the answer? We have to multiply this by 1.2 for multiple lane presence factor. So G will be equal to
0.78.
That's all. Now for multi lane, for two or more,
it will be one
lane loaded, M is equal to 1. But what is the equation for G? G is equal to 0.36 plus 0.2 plus S over. Just put the value, S is equal to exterior girder for one lane loaded, for one lane, we have to use the lever rule. And we already use this rule to find G for the moment, and we will use the same G. So we have done it before. We have found the G value for the moment by using the lever rule for one lane loaded. So the same value we are going to use it here. Can you tell me the value?
For
exterior G for a moment. So I hope you would be having the previous notes. Okay, G. So lateral distribution is one lane, and then we use lever rule, that equals 0.82 with 1.2 G. So the 1.2 G was
0.82.
We already have it. And for two or more lane loaded, G is equal to the same thing. In that case, G is equal to E into G interior, and E is equal to 0.6 plus DE over 3000, and this DE was the, we calculated this, it was the clear distance without barrier. It was the clear distance without barrier. So the overhang was how much? Our overhang is 1000 or how much?
880.
So 880 minus overhang minus barrier, it is 500. So DE is 500, and this DE, it should be how much? How much is this E?
Zero point
0.77. And G interior for two lanes loaded, this value 0.77. So how much is G?
0.77. 0.59.
So we will use this value. G is equal to 0.82. Okay, so we have the distribution factors for the shear, for interior girder and for exterior girder. Just keep these values in your mind, and now let's proceed for the longitudinal distribution. This is the lateral distribution for the shear. Lateral distribution, I tell you many times, I explain you again. For example, if the total V, there are two wheels and the girder is in between, how much shear of the each wheel will go to that girder in the lateral direction? For example, if this is your bridge girder, this way, and these are your two wheels. So theoretically, we say half, half, so the half of the total should be on the girder. But actually, if the wheel could be here, the wheel could move in the lateral direction. So what will be the maximum force effect? For example, this 0.78 means the axle load, the 80% of the total axle load you can consider on that particular bridge girder. Okay? So this is a lateral distribution. Now, for example, if the axle load is 100, for example, axle load is 100, and it is 0.78, so how much will be the load on the girder? If the axle load is 100 and G is 0.78, so how much will be the load on the girder? If the axle load is 100 and G is 0.78, how much will be the load on the girder? So it means one wheel here 78, another wheel there 78, and now you will calculate the bending moment along the length of the beam or shear force along the length of the beam. So these G factors are for the shear. So now we calculate the shear force along the length of the beam. So either you can multiply the axle load at the beginning or at the end you can multiply by the G. For example, either you multiply G at the beginning, make it 78, or at the end use 100 and at the end multiply by 0.78, you will get the same value. It will not make any difference. So what we do, you want to multiply right now or at the end? Okay, at the end. So let's do now the lateral distribution, longitudinal distribution. Well, we are now quickly approaching to the end of this topic, and then we will have exam and then we will have the computer model. Okay, so now, you know, if I have to calculate the shear force.